have you go right through this room, get you registered, your vaccine, and get your follow-up appointment. Thank you.
An average 1,500 times a day, 120 times an hour, the medical team at University Health's COVID-19 Vaccine Center puts a life-saving shot in a grateful person's arm.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. You have a great day.
Giving the vaccination may be the easy part of this process. Ensuring it all runs smoothly takes the right infrastructure, the right people, and a well-organized plan. Bill Phillips, the Senior Vice President and Chief Information Officer at University Health, is the architect.
It's a team of nursing, it's a team of registration, it's a team of pharmacy, it's a team of IT, and then there's also other individuals from the organization that we've pulled in out of various departments to help make a cohesive team.
One of the team's first jobs was to find the right location, a vacant space at a shopping mall where University Health already had a robust computer system for training.
One of the benefits it has, we're on the lower level. It has covered parking, it has multiple entrances and exits, and it's ADA accessible. So it fit the bill for all of the needs from what we needed as an organization to complete this task, and then what we needed to help the patient to complete the task.
Phillips' IT team created an online and over-the-phone scheduling program. Through the Epic electronic health record system, they booked 10 people every 5 minutes, only signing up the number for whom they knew they would have vaccine. By day one, Phillips had created an assembly line of sorts to keep people, his customers, moving.
So it begins at the entrances. We have an entrance at this end and an entrance at this end.
Ambassadors stationed at two entrances welcome those arriving, making sure the disabled have access to wheelchairs and a team who can help them get around.
They're greeted by an ambassador asking if they have an appointment for the day. If they do, then they're asked to proceed to this line over here. If they don't, most of them still come this way anyway, and they'll form a line right here to ask questions. And this is why it's extremely important to have a senior leader out here that can make decisions.
That first line moves quickly. To prevent long waits, those with confirmed appointments are called the night before and told they don't need to come early. Their appointments are secure. The team finds the person's name on their appointment list based on their scheduled time.
They fill out the CDC card with the patient's name, date of birth. The card is pre-stamped with the date of the vaccination, the type of vaccination, and then a return date.
Now, the second line, that's where some real diplomacy is needed. These people want the vaccine, but they don't have appointments.
So right now we don't currently have appointments, but as we get more vaccine from the state, we'll be opening up.
And it's very difficult to explain that we might not have any and we can't take walk-ins. You have to have that sympathetic type of person there talking to them and really relaying, we're trying to get medicine, we're trying to vaccinate as many as we can.
Most without appointments are politely told how to be aware of future vaccination scheduling. With their CDC cards in hand, individuals are then directed into the vaccination rooms.
So my primary role is to make sure that the patients are getting registered quickly and vaccinated, and that the way the flow of the clinic is going very quickly to get them in and out. So I'm placing them in each of the designated rooms to get registered, and then they'll get vaccinated, and then we'll give them a follow-up appointment for their second dose.
This is going to be your appointment for your next vaccine. So your vaccine will be February 2nd, 2021. If you go to the front desk, they will go ahead and give you the time to arrive.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.
And then we send them to the observation room to wait for about 15 minutes to make sure that they don't have any reactions to the vaccines, and then after that, they're free to leave.
Meanwhile, there's a lot going on that the public doesn't see. In a secure area, pharmacists are preparing syringes. They're keeping careful count of the vaccinations given and talking to Phillips about the doses still needed for the rest of the day.
So we have to coordinate the no-shows with the people who are actually here. And we don't want to make any extra because every dose is critical.
Bottom line, no doses will be wasted. The state of Texas requires vaccine providers to report the number of doses given, patient information, and specific vaccine delivered each day. Through Epic, that information is automatically uploaded and sent through an interface with the state's immunization registry system, making this required reporting accurate and efficient. The team is always asking the people most important to this process, the customers, how is it working?
This was fantastic. Parking was easy. My wife is handicapped, so we got a handicap space. We came right in, got greeted at the front door, promptly registered and brought back, and there's social distancing markers throughout the building, which is awesome.
From the time I parked my car, right now it's 30 minutes. It doesn't get better than that.
That's the sound of success, which makes the long days worth it.